Mocha has always excelled, not only at tracking, but also as a top-notch roto and masking tool. Today, I will show you how you can utilize matte refine and layer group compositing to get even more out of your Mocha mats, both your automated ML mats, as well as your traditional spline or Bezier mask. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects. Let's take a look. For our first example, I've got this shot of a cow on a hillside. I already tracked in some text behind the cow, but now we need a proper mat for our hero animal so that she is once again in front of the text. Let's use Mocha's object brush to create a new layer that will serve as a mat for the cow. With a couple of clicks, I get my initial mat. Now let's use Mat System L to propagate it throughout the clip. Okay, that holds up pretty well. In the Insert tab, let's pick the layer with our text and set our cow layer up as a mask for that insert. Once we invert it, it does what it is supposed to do. But if we shuttle to the area where the cow's ear is in front of the text, we see that this is our typical hard edge binary mat. Let me turn on the visibility for the cow mat and change the color of the overlay to blue. Yep, all the fine detail of the hair and fur gets lost. Let's switch to the Matte tab. There, we can activate Refine Matte. That will load a new, separate machine learning model into your graphics card. So depending on your hardware, this might take a moment. This model will take a look at both the matte and the image and try to figure out what the detail is that you might want to extract with that matte. And it will not be binary anymore, but rather have a proper grayscale to accommodate all this fuzzy detail of the cow. You can really see this here around frame 200. The fuzzy part of the ear gets a different treatment than the firmer area here. You actually have different models to choose from, and it is worth switching between them. Each model has been trained differently and gives different results. As the name suggests, softer edges produces a softer matte, and sharper edges will give you a more pronounced matte. But depending on the kind of footage you're working on, you might also get different results in regard to the temporal consistency of your matte. To the right, we've got some post-processing controls, but these will be applied after the RefineML model has done its magic. Still, some growing of our matte and a very subtle blur will really kiss this in. In our second example, we've got this shot of a performer in her dance uniform. The way I've set this up, the matte consists of four separate layers. Three of them are machine learning object mats, and then there's this one to fill in the little gaps in between. Would I now enable refine on each of my object mats, my graphics card might just get into a little bit of a sweat, because it would have to run three instances of the refined machine learning model. You can certainly do that, but if you want to save yourself some processing time, you can instead do the following. Put all of these layers into a layer group. In the Matte tab, check Composite Layers in Group. You will see a little bit of a change in the matte overlay. The whole group gets a singular matte color, the one from the bottom layer of our layer group. What Mocha is doing now is basically creating a single mat out of our four individual layers. And that means once we check refine on our layer group, Mocha will only need one instance of the machine learning model to refine the entire mat. Crisis averted, your graphics card doesn't need to go into overtime. What is really cool though with this is that once you activate the composite layers and group function, your group is available as an additional layer in Mocha's other modules like insert or remove, and also as a matte output, something we are going to explore in our final example. I already rotoed this shot of the MMA fighter, and this time I did it old school, so those are classic Mocha X-splines, no machine learning magic here, not yet. I have all these shapes in a layer group, and now I click Composite Layers and Group. As expected, I get my combined matte. Beautiful. Let's make this even more beautiful. I said before that RefineML is its own machine learning model, so it is perfectly usable on these classic shapes as well. If we switch this on, it does its refinement. And if you want to see just the edge where RefineML does get applied, check the Edge Only checkbox. That way, you can really see what is going on and choose the model that works best for your shot. And if you leave this on, you'll get just the edge rendered out, whether by using the Export Rendered Shapes dialog, all the render options in the Mocha Pro plugin. Speaking of those, there you've got the handy option to turn Refine Matte on and off without you even having to enter the Mocha interface. So this is my little quick tip on how to get more out of your Mocha mats by combining them into layered groups and using the awesome potential of Refine. Check out our other great tutorials at boriseffects.com or join the conversation on our Discord. Link is in the description. My name is Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and I will see you in another video.